Hey everybody, happy holidays and happy almost new year. I can't believe 2021 is already almost coming to a close. And to say that 2021 has been a complicated year is to really say the least about it. But it looks like My Hero Academia Vigilantes is gonna last going into 2022. Now I've seen from my Twitter feed that some of you are still kind of upset that the arc hasn't wrapped up. But I will say that chapter 116 finally gives us some plot development that chapter 114 and 115 certainly didn't give us whatsoever. But with that being said, this is your spoiler warning. If you haven't read chapter 116 of My Hero Academia Vigilantes, this one is gonna have spoilers in it, and it's gonna have theories as to what chapter 117 will entail. Cause while My Hero Academia took a break for the holiday season and is coming back later this week, My Hero Academia Vigilantes didn't take a break whatsoever, and it came out with a chapter on Friday. So if you're an avid observer of leaks, you know that this week's chapter really isn't going to develop into much. Maybe Deku gets his suit. Sorry, spoilers. But My Hero Academia Vigilantes, on the other hand, had some pretty intense character development for our boy Koichi. Now let's head inside and grab a drink, because I really gotta talk about this chapter. Alright folks, welcome to the bar. So, chapter 115 left us off with that uncertainty whether or not Koichi would survive the final attack from number 6. Now, if you watched my previous review of chapter 115, you would know from my tone of voice that I wasn't really thrilled with what happened. It just felt like a recycling of events in chapter 100. But this particular chapter is what I wanted 3 chapters ago, to be quite honest. I understand you had to tell us that number 6 had 6 individual forms to represent the fact that he's called number 6, but on the other hand, it's like, come on dude, get to the point. And I think I've proven by now that I am not the type of guy that will stand by a title if it's not doing well. I will call it out. I will say that, look, this is dry. I'm not gonna just gush over it nonstop. Of course, to a certain extent, I'm going to have a biased opinion about Vigilantes, but don't think for a second that when something happens that I don't necessarily agree with, I'm not gonna call it out. Most of y'all have kind of pointed out to me that this particular arc in Vigilantes is really overstaying its welcome. And honestly, I agree. But chapter 116 is the shot in the arm that Vigilantes so desperately needed. I'll meet you all over by the wall, I'll explain what I'm talking about. Alright, so chapter 116 starts off essentially where chapter 115 left off. At the end of chapter 115, we saw that Koichi had a broken arm and a broken leg. He skittered inside of a building, and chapter 115 ended with number 6 delivering a massive punch to the building that Koichi was seeking refuge inside of. This chapter starts with Koichi realizing that the building is starting to come down all around him, and then we start getting the perspective of all the people that reside within Naruhata. The people of the town are genuinely scared of number 6 because they seriously do not know what's going to become of their small town after this. The heroes that were on scene are reeling for number 6's nightmare night, and Koichi is currently about to fall unconscious underneath the rubble of the building. And once Koichi finally loses consciousness, we get one of the best scenes in My Hero Academia Vigilantes. Like, this was the moment that all of us wanted, but all of us feared at the exact same time. Koichi is laying there, bleeding out. He's on death's door, and he's getting ready to accept the fact that he's gonna die when all of a sudden, he hears a boot sound. Accompanied by a star that we've seen shoot through the night sky before, a familiar voice rings out and asks Koichi, is it really the end of the line? And Koichi, who's pretty much more or less at this point ready to take his last breath, completely wakes up because he realizes that his master is standing in front of him. And he wonders to himself, how are you here? And unfortunately, the next page tells us why. Now, I don't want to get teary for you guys, but I wasn't expecting this scene. We flash back to Soga, who's panicking because he sees the explosions in the distance, and he realizes that he has to stay here because he has to take care of his master. But when he gets up to see if his master is okay, it's already too late. The reason why Knuckleduster is appearing to Koichi is because he's dead. And then we go back into the singularity or whatever this is going inside of their heads, and Koichi thinks that it's him, and Knuckleduster kind of nudges him and says that, do you really think it's you? At that point, Koichi tries to move, and he realizes that, yeah, he's probably the one that's still alive because he still feels massive amounts of pain. And then we get the moment that I like to call our full cowling moment. That epiphany that Deku obtains that opens up One For All's possibilities is what happens to Koichi right here with Knuckleduster. The high-speed hero looks at his pupil and tells him, why don't you try to use your quirk, you know, all over your body? Try to bind your arm and make it into like a cast. And Koichi is like, man, that seems like really technical stuff. I don't know if I could do that. And as he says, I don't know if I could do that, he does it. Not only that, he realizes, well, if I'm able to bind my arm, what if I'm able to channel this throughout my entire body like Cap was able to? And this newfound control over his quirk grants him the ability to virtually be weightless all of the time. And right there, that's the purpose of Captain Celebrity. Koichi wouldn't have that idea to do that with his quirk if he didn't have that time with Cap. So Knuckleduster does exactly what he does best. He encourages his pupil to slow down and digest the situation. Because even when Koichi is trapped amongst the darkness and he asks Knuckleduster for a little bit more help, Knuckleduster kind of replies by saying, you really don't need my help anymore. You could do this on your own. And that's when he tells his master that he really hasn't been doing this all on his own. He's had Pop and he's had the gang. But to be quite honest, it's been kind of rough since his master went away. And that's when Knuckleduster hits him with like a final little bit more of ribbon and is like, well, if you hate it that much, you should have quit. And that's when Koichi is like, hate it. And it hasn't really been all that bad, to be quite honest. And that's when Knuckleduster kind of lays it on him. He says, look, I've only been lending you a fist every now and then at the very start. After that, the kids kind of just use their own ingenuity to make all of this work. And Koichi jokes and he's like, ingenuity? It's kind of a reach. He's just kind of half-assing everything. Knuckleduster cuts him off and goes, look, you've been honing your body and your neck. And Koichi reminds him that he's been practicing how to fall right too, because recently it's kind of hurt a lot less. And while Knuckleduster stands there proud of his student, Koichi reaches the final wall and he's like, well, I guess this is the dead end. I don't know what to do next. I guess, you know, it's my time after all. And Knuckleduster says he's been doing a killer job, which kind of gives Koichi the inkling that, okay, yeah, it is his time to die. And he starts going into a diatribe and actually admits that Knuckleduster coming into his life made his life for the better. But that's when Knuckleduster cuts him off one final time and tells him, from now on, these guys are taking center stage. And Koichi is kind of bewildered at this point because he's like, wait, the Knuckles are gonna take center stage? And then that's when the next page hits you. Yeah, the Knuckles are gonna take center stage. And that's when the hair on the back of my neck started standing up because I did not know what was gonna happen, because the next page has number 6 punch after punch laying out the building that Koichi is in. And as number 6 cocks back for one more punch, this time, the building explodes in number 6's direction because it looks like Knuckleduster left Koichi with one final gift, his gift of smashing villains in the face. Because now, Koichi is ready to go after number 6 in his final form, Knuckle style. Now, this is the point where if you watch the stream, I started losing my damn mind. The one for all motif with the single lone star and then Knuckleduster coming to Koichi in that singularity and giving him the gift of the fist? Come on, man. Not only does this encounter mirror their very first attempt to take down a villain, but for a while, this is the closest that we're ever gonna get from a student saying goodbye to their master. And this chapter just ripped emotion after emotion out of me. Like, there's so much to digest from this chapter that I'm definitely going to miss some things. So if I did, please let me know in the comments below. Because I am beyond shook upon seeing this scene. For the first time, we're actually gonna see Koichi throw the hands. Like, we've been waiting for this moment. Throughout this entire arc, we were like, okay, Koichi is just playing keep away. He's just being a defensive person. He's not really being that threat that shows every single one of us that he could be someone that absolutely destroys a villain. Well, now it's time. Koichi is done pulling his punches, and now he's gonna lay out number 6. Whether or not Knuckle style does him in, what this does is let us know, the reader, that Koichi is done pulling his punches. We're finally going to see him fight. I do want to see what his quirk does when it's channeled throughout his entire body, but first I gotta see how devastating this punch is. I've been saying that My Hero Academia is all about getting, you know, your strength passed on to you from the prior generation, and one thing that we haven't seen Koichi have is we haven't had that moment where the past kind of entrusts the future to the present. And this is it. This is where Knuckleduster tells him, look, you've been doing everything you possibly can. There's only one solution. Punch him in the face and knock him the fuck out. Look, that's the lesson that Knuckleduster learned from Rappa. Sometimes you just have to throw down. It's just the nature of the beast. The minute that Koichi became a vigilante and took on Knuckleduster as a teacher, this moment was an inevitability. The gift of the fist is something that we expected Koichi to inherit since chapter 1. And now, it's absolutely time for him to shine. Let's just hope that All For One stays where he is and doesn't appear to try to kill Koichi. Because I can tell you right now, that is a quirk that he would absolutely love to have. As for what will happen in Chapter 117, I do think that the fight between Number 6 and Koichi is going to go on for a little bit longer. I know saying that might get a lot of people fed up with the series, but Chapter 116 kind of did a good job making up for Chapter 112 through 115's faults. Like I said when we first opened up shop, I am totally on the side of everybody that thinks that this arc is really overstaying its welcome, but Chapter 116 was a very pivotal chapter. Don't get me wrong, it could have happened sooner to accelerate events, but this is becoming one of those stories, like I said, that's meant to be digested all at once. You're supposed to read one volume after another for this particular story. And stop me if I'm wrong here, because I'm not 100% sure on this one. I know I was more sure in my prior videos, but I think that Chapter 113 was the end of that most current volume, which would mean to round out the most recent volume, we would need 2 to 4 more chapters. So it's possible that there's 2 to 4 more chapters left in the series. This series could absolutely be wrapped up in 4 chapters. You have 2 chapters to end the fight and 2 chapters to end the series. It's not that hard. But honestly, what do I know? Because what I do know is if there's 10 more chapters to My Hero Academia Vigilantes, they're gonna have a lot more pissed off people on their hands than they think. You won't see me tap out on the title anytime soon, especially after Chapter 116 dropping this on us. I mean, between Knuckleduster dying and Koichi finally picking up the Knuckledusters, you got me once again. I am totally reinvested in this story once again. So let me know what you think about Chapter 116. Do you still think that this arc is overstaying its welcome? And do you think Chapter 116 kind of was that shot in the arm that I said it was? I really, really, really enjoyed this chapter. It got me teary-eyed. I full-blown cried on stream at one point. Thank God there was not a face cam or I would have been a blubbering mess. You would have seen me, but you could definitely hear it in my voice. So make sure you check out the live stream. Click the card above. Though until next time, Happy New Year, and make sure you keep them Knuckle Dusters nice and shiny. Cheers.